네, 안녕하세요. 기존에 VOA로 느린 발음으로 했었는데 좀 테드로 한번 해보겠습니다. 지금 여기는 플랫이기 때문에 확대가 돼요. 확대가 되기 때문에 글자가 깨져서 안 보인다 그런 경우는 없을 거예요. 네, 그럼 이제부터 Let's end ageism이라는 연령 차별을 끝장내자, 연령 차별을 철폐하자라는 제목으로 테드 연사가 강연하는 것을 가지고 한 단락별로 한 문장별로 한번 짚어보겠습니다. 모르는 거 중심, 단어 중심으로요. 해보겠습니다.
What's one thing that every person in this room is going to become? Older. And most of us are scared stiff at the prospect. How does that word make you feel? I used to feel the same way.
What's the one thing that most every person, what's the one thing that every person in this room is going to become? Older. And most of us are scared, stiff at the prospect. How does that word make you feel? I used to feel the same way. 자, 모르는 단어, 어려운 단어, stiff, 경직되다. 어디 앞에서? At the prospect, 전망 앞에서. 나는 종종 그렇게 느끼곤 했다. 나도 그렇게 느낍니다. 여러분과 같은 고민입니다.
Older, and most of us are scared stiff at the prospect. How does that word make you feel? I used to feel the same way. What was I most worried about?
What was I most worried about? What was I most worried about?
Ending up drooling in some grim institutional hallway.
Ending up drooling in some grim institutional hallway. Drooling, 침 흘리다. 결국에는 침을 흘리게 되고 마는 것. 어디에서 어떤 음침한 institutional hallway, 보호시설의 복도에서 죽는다는 거겠죠.
And then I learned that only 4% of older Americans are living in nursing homes.
이거 나는 알게 되었습니다. And then I learned that only 4% of older Americans are living in nursing homes. 양론의 4% 산다는 것이 비극입니까? 희극입니까? 제가 아는 분은 한 달에 100만 원가량을 들려서 어머님을 부양하고 계시던데요. 양론에서. 보호 요양시설이라고 그러죠. 그것이 비극입니까? 희극입니까? 4%가 5%가 됐다는 말이 좋다는 말입니까? 나빠졌다는 말입니까?
The percentage is dropping. What else was I worried about?
그 퍼센트는 줄어들었습니다. And the percentage is dropping. What else was I worried about? The percent is dropping. 그 퍼센트는 줄어들고 있습니다. 결국은 이 연사부는 양로 보호 요양시설, 양로원에서 상주하고 있는 거주하고 있는 할머니 할아버지들이 많을수록 안 좋다는 거로 보고 있는 거죠. 줄어들고 있습니다. 끝까지 읽어 들어보시면 아십니다.
Dementia.
Dementia.
Turns out that most of us can think just fine to the end.
Dementia. Turns out that most of us can think just fine to the end. Turns out that most of us can think just fine to the end. Turns out 밝혀졌습니다. 드러났습니다. 뭐가? 우리들 대부분이 can think 생각할 수 있다는 거. Just fine. 별 문제가 없는 것으로 생각하고 있다고 밝혀졌습니다. To the end, 죽을 때까지. 죽을 때까지 우리들 대부분은 괜찮게 별 문제 없이 생각할 수 있다는 것이 밝혀졌습니다. 왜요?
Dementia rates are dropping too.
치매율이 또한 떨어지기 때문에 우리는 정상적으로 죽을 때까지 생각할 수 있습니다. 그런 말이죠. 양로원에 계신 분들이 많을수록 안 좋다. 양로원에 계신 그 비율이 적을수록 떨어질수록 좋다. 그런 입장이에요.
The real epidemic is anxiety over memory loss.
The real epidemic is anxiety of memory loss. 진짜 병은 저 에퍼데믹은 전염병에 확산되는 전염병에 뭐 그런 말로 쓰이는데요. 이것이 더 심각하다는 거죠. 정말 확산되는 전염병처럼 확산되는 심각한 리얼 에퍼데믹은 불안이다, 공포다, 뭐에 대한 오버 메모리 러스, 기억 상실에 대한 불안이다.
I also figured that old people were depressed
I also figured that old people were depressed.
because they were old and they were going to die soon.
Because they are old and they are gonna die soon.
It turns out that the longer people live, the less they fear dying.
It turns out that the longer people live, the less they fear dying.
And that people are happiest at the beginnings and the ends of their lives. It's called the U-curve of happiness.
And the people are happiest at the beginnings and the end of their lives. It's called U-curve of happiness.
And it's been borne out by dozens of studies around the world. You don't
It's been borne out by dozens of studies around the world. 세계 여러 유수한 연구진에 의해서 밝혀진 바에 의하면 그렇다는 거죠.
You don't have to be a Buddhist or a billionaire.
You don't have to be Buddhist or billionaire. 그냥 평범하게 생각해도 알수 있는 것이란 거죠.
The curve is a function of the way aging itself affects the brain.
The curve is a function of the way. 함수다란 말의 function이 기능이란 말이 아니고 함수다. 이 곡선은 함수입니다. 그 방식의 함수입니다. 그 자체, aging itself, aging, 나이 드는 현상, 노화 현상 그 자체가 영향을 끼치는, 뇌에 영향을 끼치는 그 방식의 함수입니다.
So, I started feeling a lot better about getting older.
So I started feeling a lot better about getting old. So I started feeling a lot better. So I started feeling a lot better about getting older.
And I started obsessing about why so few people know these things.
And I started obsessing about why so few people know these things. And I started obsessing about why so few people know these things. 자, obsess란 말은 이제 관념이 강박화되다. 그런 말인데 여기서는 thinking. 생각하다, 골몰이 생각하다. 뭔가를 사람들이 너무 골몰이 빠지게 되면은 헤어나지를 못하잖아요. 그래서 obsess라는 의미를 그렇게 썼는데, 근데 이분은 여기에 골몰돌이 생각하게 됐습니다. 왜 적은 사람들이 이것을 알고 있는가?
The reason is ageism,
The reason is ageism.
discrimination and stereotyping on the basis of age.
The discrimination and stereotyping on the basis of age. 나이라는 것을 토대로 해서 정형화시키고 차별하는 것. 즉, 에이지즘의 정의를 말하는 거죠.
We experience it anytime someone assumes we're too old for something.
We experience it anytime. We experience it anytime. Someone assumes we are too old for something.
Instead of finding out who we are and what we're capable of.
Instead of finding out who we are and what we are capable of, 우리가 누구인지, 우리가 무엇을 할수 있는지를 발견하지 않고 그 대신에 뭔가에 너무 늙었다라고 가정하는 것을 우리는 그런 때 우리는 경험합니다. 뭘 경험해요? 에이지즘을.
Or too young. Ageism.
나이가 늙어서 무슨 일을 못한다라는 것도 있지만 내가 너무 어려서 못한다. 디스크 에이지즘은 연령 차별은 나이 든 사람에만 해당되는 것이 아니고 나이가 어린 사람한테도 해당된다.
Cuts both ways.
Ageism cuts both ways. 연령 차별은 두 가지 경우 다 해당된다.
All isms are socially constructed ideas. Racism, sexism, homophobia, and that means we make them up.
모든 주의 주장, 모든 경향, 모든 좋지 않은 사고 방식은 사회적으로 형성됩니다. 사회적으로 형성되는 생각들입니다. 예를 들어서 인종차별주의, 레이시즘, 섹시즘, 성차별주의, 호모포비아, 동성애 차별주의 이런 것들을 말하는 거죠. And that means we make them up. 그것이 말하는 것은 이러한 모든 이즘들은 우리가 만드는 것이다.
And they can change over time.
그리고 그 이즘은 시간에 따라 변화할 수 있습니다.
All these prejudices pit us against each other to make
모든 이러한 편견들은 우리로 하여금 서로와 겨루게 합니다. Pit us against each other to maintain the status quo. 현상 유지를 말하는 거죠. 현 상태, status quo.
Maintain the status quo.
네, 이게 좀 이 연사의 특별한 유별난 점인데요. 이러한 통찰이 가능하게 된 것은 이 연사본이 이론적으로 연령차별주의를 경험한 것이 이론적으로만 경험한 것이 아니라 실천을 통해서 현실에서 부닥치는 벽을 이분이 가지고 있는 거예요. 그래서 이분은 신념화된 말로 듣는 사람의 마음을 움직이고 있는 것이죠.
Like auto workers in the US competing against auto workers in Mexico instead of organizing for better wages.
Like auto workers in the US competing against auto workers in Mexico instead of organizing for better wages. 이렇게 서로 pit us. 이러한 편견들은 우리로 하여금 서로 간에 겨루게 합니다의 사례를 얘기하는 거죠. Like 어떤 거? 미국 자동차 제조업 근로자가 멕시코 자동차 제조업 근로자들과 경쟁하게 된 것처럼 Like auto workers in the US competing against auto workers in Mexico 임금을 좀 더 양호하게 받기 위해서 조직하는 문제로 골몰하는 게 아니고 경쟁하게 만든다는 거예요. 미국의 제조업 근로자들이 멕시코, 더 후진국인 멕시코의 제조업 근로자들과 경쟁하게 이러한 편견들이 부추긴다는 거죠. Pit us against each other. Pit us against each other. 겨루게 합니다. Pit us against each other.
Each other to maintain the status quo, like auto workers in the U.S. competing against auto workers in Mexico instead of organizing for better wages. We know it's not okay to allocate resources by race or by sex.
We know it's not okay to allocate resources by race or by sex. 우리는 다 아는 바와 같이 옳지 않습니다. To allocate 할당하는 것은 자원들을 뭘 중고로 해서 by race or by sex 성이나 gender 인종이나 성을 가지고 그런 중고를 가지고 자원을 배분하는 것은 옳지 않다는 것은 아는데
Why should it be okay to weigh the needs of the young against the old?
왜 우리는 그것을 오케이여야만 합니까? 젊은 사람들의 요구를 나이 든 사람과 재는 거. 재는 것은 왜 문제가 안 됩니까? 왜 오케이입니까?
All prejudice relies on othering, seeing a group of people as other than ourselves.
모든 편견은 어디에 의존합니까? Ordering. 순서화 시키는 거. 구분화 시키는 것에 의존합니다. 사람의 무리를 우리 자신 우리 자신으로서가 우리 자신보다도 타인으로서 사람들의 무리를 보는, 즉 오더링하는 것. 그러니까 자신의 문제가 아니라 제 3자의 문제로 오더링하는 것, 구분하는 것. 거기에 의존합니다.
Other race, other religion, other nationality.
다른 인종, 다른 종교, 다른 국적.
The strange thing about ageism, that other is us.
자, 연령 차별에 있어서는 여기서 말하는 다른은 바로 우리 자신입니다.
Ageism feeds on denial, our reluctance to acknowledge that we are going to become that older person.
Ageism feeds on denial, our reluctance to acknowledge that you are going to become that older person. Feeds on, 뭐뭐를 먹고 산다 그 말. 뭘 먹고 살아? 부정을 먹고 산다. 그 부정이 뭐냐면 우리가 안 하려는 거, 인정하지 않으려는 거, 뭘 인정하지 않아? 우리가 그렇게 된다는 것을, 될 것이라는 것을, 그 늙은 사람이 될 것이라는 것을 인정하지 않는다는 거.
It's denial when we try to pass for younger.
그것은 부정입니다. 언제 우리가 이렇게 할 때 pass for younger, 더 어려 보이는 것으로 통하고 싶어 할 때의 부정입니다.
Or when we believe in anti-aging products.
Or when we believe in anti-aging products.
Or when we feel like our bodies are betraying us.
그리고 우리가 느낄 때 우리 몸이 우리를 배반한다고 느낄 때, 그때가 바로 우리가 부정하는 때라는 거예요.
Simply because they are changing.
그냥 변하기 때문에, 변한다는 그 사실만으로 아, 내 몸이 나를 배반하고 있구나라고 느끼는 거.
Why on earth do we stop celebrating the ability to adapt and grow as we move through life?
Why on earth? 세상에 on earth란 말이 지구상 위에 그런 말이 아니, 그런 말로 직역하지 마시고 세상에 그렇잖아요. 지구 저 on earth 세상에 Why do we stop? 왜 우리는 멈춥니까? Celebrating 하는 거를, the ability, 우리 능력을 축하하는 것을 멈춥니까? 어떤 능력? 적응하고 커지는 능력, 성장하는 능력, 몸무게에 따라 우리가 인생을 살아감에 따라 여러분들 이렇게 말을 하는 것은 미국인들이 서구인 영어를 상용어로 쓰는 분들이 이렇게 말을 안 해요. 이렇게 말을 안 하는데 그 이쪽에 문어체인데 여러분들 이걸 쭉 따라하다 보시면 아시겠지만 이분들은 대본이 있어요. 그 대본을 일단 암기를 하고 완전히 이해해서 체화하여서 말을 하는 거예요. 그러니까 대본을 안 보고도 원본을 그대로 말할 수 있는 거예요. 왜냐하면 원본의 아이디어를 완전히 체득했기 때문에. 근데 실제로 이 구어체에서는 이런 식으로 표현을 잘 안 하죠. 그렇죠? 영화에서도 이런 식으로 말하는 미드나 영드는 없어요. 심파극 같은 옛날 올드 스타일은 있겠지만 지금 80년대 이후의 영드 미디어는 이런 것들이 없어요. 근데 이런 분들은 도대체 어떻게 해서 이분은 어떻게 해서 이렇게 이 어려운 말을 대본도 안 보고 11분 25초 동안 구구절절 이렇게 말할 수 있을까? 그것은 여러분들도 가능한 거예요. 여러분들이 가지고 있는 이슈를 고민하는 부분을 대중들 앞에서 얘기할 경우에 10분 안에 얘기 못할 것 같아요. 여러분들이 직접 대본을 작성을 하고 한다면 충분히 할 수 있는 거예요. 그러니까 여러분들 이 사람들은 이 말을 어떻게 이렇게 잘할까 의아해하지 마시고 이 사람들이 말하는 그 아이디어를 정확히 따라하시면 됩니다.
Why should aging well mean struggling to look and move like younger versions of ourselves?
Why should aging well mean struggling to look and move like younger versions of ourselves? 잘 늙는다는 거죠. Aging well. 잘 늙는다. 잘 늙는다는 것은 왜 의미해야만 합니까? 의미합니까? Struggling to look. 보이게끔 struggling. 막 애쓰는 거. 그리고 움직이는 것처럼 보이고 움직이려고 애쓰는 거. 어떻게? 뭐뭐처럼 젊은 버전의 우리 자신처럼 젊었을 때 우리 자신처럼 보이고 움직이려고 애를 쓰는 것을 의미합니까? 잘 늙는다는 것은
It's embarrassing to be called out as older until we quit being embarrassed about it.
It's embarrassing. 참 부끄러운 일입니다. Called out as older. 더 늙었다라고 따로 불리워지는 것은 따로 늙었다고 불리워지는 것만큼 불리워지는 것은 부끄러운 일인데 언제까지 그러냐면 우리가 거기에 대해서 더 이상 부끄러워하지 않으면 부끄러운 일이 아닌데 부끄러워할 때까지는 부끄러운 일이다.
And it's not healthy to go through life dreading our futures. The sooner we get off this hamster wheel of age denial,
and it's not healthy to go through life dreading our futures. It's not healthy to go through life dreading our futures. The sooner we get off this hamster wheel of age denial, it's not healthy to go through life dreading our futures. 미래를 두려워하며 인생을 사는 것은 건강하지 않습니다. The sooner we get off this hamster wheel of age denial, 이 나이 부정이라는 햄스터 쳇바퀴에서 더 빨리 나갈수록 내려올수록 the better off we are.
The better off we are. Stereotypes are always a mistake, of course, but especially when it comes to age, because the longer we live, the more different from one another we become, right?
자, 고정관념을 갖는 것은 항상 실수이죠, 물론.
But especially when it comes to age.
특히 나이에 관해서는 그렇습니다.
Because the longer we live,
왜냐하면 더 오래 살수록
the more different from one another we become, right?
더 달라지기 때문입니다. 서로에 대해서.
Think about it. And yet, we tend to think of everyone in a retirement home as the same age.
여전히 우리는 모든 사람들, 요양보호소에 있는 사람들을 같은 나이, 늙었다 라고 생각합니다. 우리가 외국 사람들을 볼 때도 유럽인, 아프리카인, 그리고 오스트레일리아 사람 이런 사람들을 다 미국 사람으로 보잖아요. 구분이 안 가는 거죠. 그것처럼 양로원에 있는 사람들은 모두 다 늙었다, 늙으니 라고 스테레오타입 정형화 시킨다는 거죠.
Old. When they can span four decades, can you imagine thinking that way about a group of people between the ages of 20 and 60?
근데 can span four decades. 그들 40년의 시간을 아우르는 나이대일 수도 있는데. Can you imagine thinking that way about a group of people between the ages of 20 and 60?
Between the ages of 20 and 60? When you get to a party, do you head for people your own age?
당신이 파티에 갔을 때 do you head? 어디로 향하다, 머리라는 뜻인데 어디로, 어느 쪽으로 가다, 어디를 향하다. For people, 어떤 사람들을 향하여? 당신의 나이 또래를 향하여 갑니까?
Have you ever grumbled about entitled millennials?
혹시 자기밖에 모르는 밀레니얼 세대를 욕한 적이 있으신가요? Grumbled against, grumbled, 불평불만을 하다. Millennials라는 표현 잘 기억하세요. 2000년대 이후에 세대들을 보통 밀레니얼이라고 하는데 좀 이기적이고 자기 자신밖에 모르고 그런 경향이 있는 그런 사람들을 욕한 적 있으신가요?
Have you ever rejected a haircut or a relationship or an outing because it's not age appropriate?
Have you ever rejected a haircut or relationship or an outing because it's not age appropriate?
For adults, there's no such thing. All these behaviors are ageist.
성인을 위해서는 그런 것은 없다는 말 하잖아요. All these behaviors are ageist. 이런 식으로 말하는 건 다 연령 차별주의라는 거예요.
We all do them, and we can't challenge bias unless we're aware of it. Nobody's born ageist, but it starts in early childhood.
누구든지 모두 다 태어나면서부터 연령 차별주의자는 아닌데 어린 시절부터 시작된다는 거예요.
Around the same time, attitudes towards race and gender start to form.
Start to form, 형성되기 시작한다.
Because negative messages about late life bombard us.
Bombard, 폭탄이 터진다는 말이에요. 우리를 폭탄이 터진 그 파편이 우리에게 오듯이 하황온기의 삶에 대한 부정적인 메시지가 우리에게 쏟아져 온다는 거예요.
From the media and popular culture at every turn.
우리가 돌아서는 곳곳마다 every turn, turn left, turn right, turn up, turn down, 동서남북 좌우 상하 어디로 턴하든지 간에 어디로 향하든지 간에 every turn 모든 곳에 있어서 미디어나 방송 미디어 매체나 대중 문화로부터 부정적인 메시지가 우리한테 주입되기 때문이죠.
Right, wrinkles are ugly. Old people are pathetic.
주름살은 흉해요. 늙은 사람은 불쌍해요.
It's sad to be old.
늙는다는 것은 슬픈 일이에요.
Look at Hollywood.
자, 할리우드 영화계에도 한번 보면은 똑같다는 거예요.
A survey of recent Best Picture nominations found that only 12% of speaking or named characters were age 60 and up. And
A survey of recent Best Picture nominations. 최근 작품상 후보들을 조사해 보니까 발견하게 되는 것이 12%의 화자나 이름 매겨진 캐릭터 역할 단 12%만이 60세거나 그 이상인데
12% of speaking or named characters were age 60 and up and many of them were portrayed as impaired.
그들 대부분이 어떻게 묘사되고 있느냐 하면은 불편하거나 아픈 것으로 묘사되고 있다. Impaired of hearing 그러면은 청각이 손상된 그런 말입니다.
Older people can be the most ageist of all because we've had a lifetime to internalize these messages.
나이 든 사람들은 가장 연령 차별주의자가 될 수가 있어요. 나이 연령 차별주의가 나이 든 사람 나이 적은 사람 상관없이 모두 다 피해자가 될 수 있는데 그 가해자가 나이 든 사람일 수도 있다는 거야. 왜냐하면은 우리는 인생 전체에 걸쳐서 이런 메시지 연령 차별주의를 강화시키는 정보나 메시지를 인터널라이즈 체화시키기 때문입니다.
And we've never thought to challenge them.
그리고 그것에 대해서 도전하려고 생각을 안 해요.
I had to acknowledge it.
나도 인정합니다.
And stop colluding.
그리고 똑같은 사람 되기를 멈춰야 했습니다. Collude 하면은 한통속이 되다 그런 말이에요. C-O-L-L-U-D-E 한통속이 되다. Collude. Stop이라는 동사가 그 다음에 ing형을 썼을 때 목적어가 되거든요. 근데 stop to collude 하면 오해의 서주가 있어요. 한통속이 되기 위해서 멈춰섰다 그런 말이거든요. 그러니까 한통속이 되는 것을 그만뒀다라고 표현할 때는 stop colluding 이렇게 말이 됩니다.
Senior moment quips, for example.
Senior moment라는 은어가 있어요. 노인 건망증을 가리키는 말인데요. Quips, 재담. 은어를 사용해서 하는 말, quips.
I stopped making them when it dawned on me that when I lost the car keys in high school.
나 이런 말을 안 해요. 왜냐하면 나의 어렸을 때도 그런 기억력이 없는 때가 있기 때문이죠.
I didn't call it a junior moment.
그렇다고 해서 그걸 junior moment라고 하지 않죠.
Like I stopped blaming my sore knee on being 64.
나는 나의 근데 이 경우에도 한쪽 다리가 아프다, 한쪽 다리가 안 아프다 이렇게 얘기가 나오는데 한번 들어보세요.
My other knee doesn't hurt and it's just as old. We are all worried about.
제가 이거 한 라인 한 라인씩 설명을 한 다음에 처음부터 끝까지 한번 그대로 들어드릴게요. 그러니까 제 설명을 듣고 싶지 않으신 분은 좀 뒤쪽으로 빼서 화면에 이 플레이백을 뒤로 빼서 들으시면 돼요. 이 원래 강의는 11분밖에 안 돼요.
Some aspect of getting older.
우리는 모두 걱정합니다. 뭐에 대해서 또 어떠한 측면에 대해서 늙는 것은 늙어진다는 측면에 대해서 걱정합니다.
Whether running out of money.
돈이 없어지면 어떡하나.
Getting sick.
아프면 어떡하나.
Ending up alone.
결국 고독해지면 어떡하나.
And those fears are legitimate and real.
이런 두려움은 당연하고 현실이죠.
But what never dawns on most of us is that the experience of reaching old age can be most of us is that the experience of reaching old age can be better or worse depending on the culture in which it takes place. It is not having a vagina that makes life harder for women. It's sexist. 이지즘. When labels are hard to read or there's no handrail or we can't open the damn jar. We blame ourselves. Our failure to age successfully. Instead of the ageism that makes those natural transitions shameful and the discrimination that makes those barriers acceptable. You can't make money off satisfaction.
만족감은 돈 되는 시장이 될 수 없습니다. 만족감으로부터 비롯하지가 않습니다. 돈 버는 일은 만족감으로부터 비롯되는 것이 아니라 불만족과 불안과 그런 것으로부터 시작된다. 그런 것을 이용해서 돈을 번다. 기업들이.
But shame and fear create markets.
Shame and fear create markets.
And capitalism always needs new markets. Who says wrinkles are ugly? The multi-billion dollar skincare industry. Who says perimenopause and low T and mild cognitive impairment are medical conditions? The trillion dollar pharmaceutical industry. The more clearly we see these forces at work, the easier it is to come up with alternative, more positive, and more accurate narratives. Aging is not a problem to be fixed or a disease to be cured. It is a natural, powerful, lifelong process that unites us all. Changing the culture is a tall order, I know that, but culture is fluid. Look at how much the position of women has changed in my lifetime, or the incredible strides that the gay rights movement has made in just a few decades, right? Look at gender. We used to think of it as a binary, male or female, and now we understand it's a spectrum. It is high time to ditch the old young binary too.
Ditch, 버리다.
There is no line in the sand between old and young after which it's all downhill. And the longer we wait to challenge that idea, the more damage it does to ourselves and our place in the world. Like in the workforce, where age discrimination is rampant. In Silicon Valley, engineers are getting Botox and hair.
실리콘밸리에서 신입사원을 뽑을 때 얘기가 나와요.
Plugged before key interviews, and these are skilled white men in their 30s. So imagine the effects further down the food chain.
자, 이 부분을 다시 한번 들어볼까요? 먹이 사슬이라는 말이 여기 갑자기 왜 나올까? 잘 들어보세요.
Challenge that idea, the more damage it does to ourselves and our place in the world. Like in the workforce, where age discrimination is rampant. In Silicon Valley, engineers are getting Botox and hair plugged before key interviews. And these are skilled white men in their 30s. So imagine the effects further down the food chain.
이렇게 연령차별주의와 성차별주의의 문화에서 선별된 사람들이 주도가 돼서 기술이 개발되고 상품이 개발되고 유통시키는 이런 기업 풍토 문화 그 아래에서 또 어떤 사람들이 또 선별돼서 상품 소비자가 되고 또 영업을 하고 이럴 것인가 그 먹이 사슬을 얘기하는 거죠.
The personal and economic consequences are devastating. Not one stereotype about older workers holds up under scrutiny. Companies aren't adaptable and creative because their employees are young. They're adaptable and creative despite it. Companies... We know that diverse companies aren't just better places to work, they work better. And just like race and sex, age is a criterion for diversity. A growing body of fascinating research shows that attitudes towards aging affect how our minds and bodies function at the cellular level. When we talk to older people like this, or call them sweetie or young lady, it's called elder speak, they appear to instantly age, walking and talking less competently.
제가 이 강의를 동영상으로 하는 것뿐만 아니라 게시판에다가 이 동영상의 원본을 올려놓을 테니까 웹상의 URL이니까 그 들어가셔갖고 다시 확인하시면 돼요. 이 오리지널 버전하고 코리안 버전하고 두 개를 다시 비교해서 확인할 수가 있어요. 이제 게시판에 동영상만 뜨는 게 아니고 동영상 말고 다른 것도 뜨니까 그 뜨는 것을 보시고 들어가서 확인하시면 돼요.
People with more positive feelings towards aging walk faster, they do better on memory tests, they heal quicker, and they live longer. Even with brains full of plaques and tangles, some people stayed sharp to the end. What did they have in common? A sense of purpose. And what's the biggest obstacle to having a sense of purpose in late life? A culture that tells us that getting older means shuffling off stage.
Shuffling at the shuffling. 발을 질질 끌다라는 말이에요. 그리고 셔틀 버스 할 때 그 셔틀, 스페이스 셔틀 할 때 그 셔틀은 F가 아니고 T죠. 그것은 왕복선, 갔다 왔다 왕복하다 그런 뜻이고요. 셔플, 발을 질질 끌다.
That's why the World Health Organization is developing a global anti-ageism initiative to extend not just lifespan, but health span. Women experience the double whammy of ageism and sexism. So,
whammy 할 때 whammy는 꽝이란 말이에요. whammy란 그룹 아시죠? The last Christmas I gave my heart. 그 노래를 부른 whammy 그룹 아시죠? 그 whammy에다가 my를 더 붙인 거예요. 꽝 부닥치다.
We experience aging differently. There's a double standard at work here. Shocker. The notion that aging enhances men and devalues women. Women reinforce this double standard when we compete to stay young. Another punishing and losing proposition.
자, proposition 할 때 position은 무슨 말인지 아시죠? 그 앞에 pro가 붙은 거예요. proposition. 발제, 의제, 제안, 과제 여러 가지 의미로 쓰이죠.
Does any woman in this room really believe that she is a lesser version? Less interesting, less fun in bed, less valuable than the woman she once was. This discrimination affects our health, our well-being, and our income. And the effects add up over time. They are further compounded by race and by class, which is why everywhere in the world, the poorest of the poor are old women of color. What's the takeaway from that map? By 2050, one out of five of us, almost 2 billion people, will be age 60 and up. Longevity is a fundamental hallmark of human progress. All these older people represent a vast, unprecedented, and untapped market. And yet, capitalism and urbanization have propelled age bias into every corner of the globe, from Switzerland, where elders fare the best, to Afghanistan, which sits at the bottom of the global Age Watch Index. Half of the world's countries aren't mentioned on that list because we don't bother to collect data on almost 2 million people because they're no longer young. Almost two-thirds of people over 60 around the world say they have trouble accessing health care. Almost three-quarters say their income doesn't cover basic services like food, water, electricity, and decent housing. Is this the world we want our children, who may well live to be 100, to inherit? Everyone, all ages, all genders, all nationalities, is old or future old. And unless we put an end to it, ageism will oppress us all. And that makes it a perfect target for collective advocacy. Why add another ism to the list?
타겟이란 말 여러분들 아시죠? 타겟, 목표 지점 그런 말이죠. 그래서 목적이라고도 말할 수 있는데 타겟. 죄송합니다. 끊어갖고.
When so many, racism in particular, call out for action, here's the thing. We don't have to choose. When we make the world a better place to grow old in, we make it a better place in which to be from somewhere else, to have a disability, to be queer, to be non-rich, to be non-white. And when we show up at all ages, for whatever cause matters most to us, save the whales, save the democracy, we not only make that effort more effective, we dismantle ageism in the process. Longevity is here to stay. A movement to end ageism is underway. I'm in it, and I hope you will join me.
Let's do it, let's do it 이렇게 나오는데 이제는 실제 장면을 보시면서 지금 대본을 봤던 거를 상기해 보세요. 처음부터
What's one thing that every person in this room is going to become? Older. And most of us are scared stiff at the prospect. How does that word make you feel? I used to feel the same way. What was I most worried about? Ending up drooling in some grim institutional hallway. And then I learned that only 4% of older Americans are living in nursing homes, and the percentage is dropping. What else was I worried about? Dementia. Turns out that most of us can think just fine to the end. Dementia rates are dropping too. The real epidemic is anxiety over memory loss. I also figured that old people were depressed because they were old and they were going to die soon. It turns out that the longer people live, the less they fear dying, and that people are happiest at the beginnings and the ends of their lives. It's called the U-curve of happiness. And it's been borne out by dozens of studies around the world. You don't have to be a Buddhist or a billionaire. The curve is a function of the way aging itself affects the brain. So I started feeling a lot better about getting older, and I started obsessing about why so few people know these things. The reason is ageism, discrimination and stereotyping on the basis of age. We experience it anytime someone assumes we're too old for something, instead of finding out who we are and what we're capable of, or too young. Ageism cuts both ways. All isms are socially constructed ideas. Racism, sexism, homophobia, and that means we make them up, and they can change over time. All these prejudices pit us against each other to maintain the status quo, like auto workers in the US competing against auto workers in Mexico instead of organizing for better wages. We know it's not okay to allocate resources by race or by sex. Why should it be okay to weigh the needs of the young against the old? All prejudice relies on othering, seeing a group of people as other than ourselves, other race, other religion, other nationality. The strange thing about ageism, that other is us. Ageism feeds on denial, our reluctance to acknowledge that we are going to become that older person. It's denial when we try to pass for younger, or when we believe in anti-aging products, or when we feel like our bodies are betraying us simply because they are changing. Why on earth do we stop celebrating the ability to adapt and grow as we move through life? Why should aging well mean struggling to look and move like younger versions of ourselves? It's embarrassing to be called out as older until we quit being embarrassed about it. And it's not healthy to go through life dreading our futures. The sooner we get off this hamster wheel of age denial, the better off we are. Stereotypes are always a mistake, of course, but especially when it comes to age, because the longer we live, the more different from one another we become, right? Think about it. And yet, we tend to think of everyone in a retirement home as the same age, old. When they can span four decades, can you imagine thinking that way about a group of people between the ages of 20 and 60? When you get to a party, do you head for people your own age? Have you ever grumbled about entitled millennials? Have you ever rejected a haircut, or a relationship, or an outing because it's not age-appropriate? For adults, there's no such thing. All these behaviors are ageist. We all do them, and we can't challenge bias unless we're aware of it. Nobody's born ageist, but it starts in early childhood, around the same time attitudes towards race and gender start to form, because negative messages about late life bombard us from the media and popular culture at every turn. Right? Wrinkles are ugly. Old people are pathetic. It's sad to be old. Look at Hollywood. A survey of recent Best Picture nominations found that only 12% of speaking or named characters were age 60 and up, and many of them were portrayed as impaired. Older people can be the most ageist of all because we've had a lifetime to internalize these messages and we've never thought to challenge them. I had to acknowledge it and stop colluding. Senior moment quips, for example, I stopped making them when it dawned on me that when I lost the car keys in high school, I didn't call it a junior moment. Like I stopped blaming my sore knee on being 64. My other knee doesn't hurt, and it's just as old. We are all worried about some aspect of getting older, whether running out of money, getting sick, ending up alone, and those fears are legitimate and real. But what never dawns on most of us is that the experience of reaching old age can be better or worse depending on the culture in which it takes place. It is not having a vagina that makes life harder for women. It's sexism. It's not loving a man that makes life harder for gay guys. It's homophobia. And it is not the passage of time that makes getting older so much harder than it has to be. It is ageism. When labels are hard to read, or there's no handrail, or we can't open the damn jar, we blame ourselves, our failure to age successfully, instead of the ageism that makes those natural transitions shameful and the discrimination that makes those barriers acceptable. You can't make money off satisfaction, but shame and fear create markets, and capitalism always needs new markets. Who says wrinkles are ugly? The multi-billion dollar skincare industry. Who says perimenopause and low T and mild cognitive impairment are medical conditions? The trillion-dollar pharmaceutical industry. The more clearly we see these forces at work, the easier it is to come up with alternative, more positive, and more accurate narratives. Aging is not a problem to be fixed or a disease to be cured. It is a natural, powerful, lifelong process that unites us all. Changing the culture is a tall order, I know that, but culture is fluid. Look at how much the position of women has changed in my lifetime, or the incredible strides that the gay rights movement has made in just a few decades, right? Look at gender. We used to think of it as a binary, male or female, and now we understand it's a spectrum. It is high time to ditch the old young binary too. There is no line in the sand between old and young after which it's all downhill. And the longer we wait to challenge that idea, the more damage it does to ourselves and our place in the world. Like in the workforce, where age discrimination is rampant. In Silicon Valley, engineers are getting Botox and hair plugged before key interviews. And these are skilled white men in their 30s, so imagine the effects further down the food chain. The personal and economic consequences are devastating. Not one stereotype about older workers holds up under scrutiny. Companies aren't adaptable and creative because their employees are young. They're adaptable and creative despite it. Companies... We know that diverse companies aren't just better places to work, they work better. And just like race and sex, age is a criterion for diversity. A growing body of fascinating research shows that attitudes towards aging affect how our minds and bodies function at the cellular level. When we talk to older people like this, or call them sweetie or young lady, it's called elder speak, they appear to instantly age, walking and talking less competently. People with more positive feelings towards aging walk faster, they do better on memory tests, they heal quicker, and they live longer. Even with brains full of plaques and tangles, some people stayed sharp to the end. What did they have in common? A sense of purpose. And what's the biggest obstacle to having a sense of purpose in late life? A culture that tells us that getting older means shuffling off stage. That's why the World Health Organization is developing a global anti-ageism initiative to extend not just lifespan, but health span. Women experience the double whammy of ageism and sexism, so we experience aging differently. There's a double standard at work here, shocker. The notion that aging enhances men and devalues women. Women reinforce this double standard when we compete to stay young. Another punishing and losing proposition. Does any woman in this room really believe that she is a lesser version, less interesting, less fun in bed, less valuable than the woman she once was? This discrimination affects our health, our well-being, and our income, and the effects add up over time. They are further compounded by race and by class, which is why everywhere in the world, the poorest of the poor are old women of color. What's the takeaway from that map? By 2050, one out of five of us, almost 2 billion people, will be age 60 and up. Longevity is a fundamental hallmark of human progress. All these older people represent a vast, unprecedented, and untapped market. And yet, capitalism and urbanization have propelled age bias into every corner of the globe. From Switzerland, where elders fare the best, to Afghanistan, which sits at the bottom of the Global Age Watch Index. Half of the world's countries aren't mentioned on that list because we don't bother to collect data on almost 2 million people because they're no longer young. Almost two-thirds of people over 60 around the world say they have trouble accessing health care. Almost three-quarters say their income doesn't cover basic services like food, water, electricity, and decent housing. Is this the world we want our children, who may well live to be 100, to inherit? Everyone, all ages, all genders, all nationalities, is old or future old. And unless we put an end to it, ageism will oppress us all. And that makes it a perfect target for collective advocacy. Why add another ism to the list when so many, racism in particular, call out for action? Here's the thing, we don't have to choose. When we make the world a better place to grow old in, we make it a better place in which to be from somewhere else, to have a disability, to be queer, to be non-rich, to be non-white. And when we show up at all ages, for whatever cause matters most to us, save the whales, save the democracy, we not only make that effort more effective, we dismantle ageism in the process. Longevity is here to stay. A movement to end ageism is underway. I'm in it. And I hope you will join me.